Did you miss spontaneous sketching? What's up, friends? Liron here. Thank you for joining me in another video. It's been a while since I did one of the spontaneous sketching videos, and so today I wanted to do something like that with a beautiful view based on a picture I took in Akko. I was there on vacation. It's in the north of Israel, just a beautiful city. This is a picture I took in the old city, and just a very lovely place. Also, some of you may have seen the boat on Instagram that I posted, both the picture and the painting. So anyway, I just thought it could be cool to do the sketch based on a view I actually saw like a week or so ago. So let's get to business. So friends, let's begin. Let's start this sketch. I have a genius setup here. I just was able to place my laptop just in front of me so I can actually see the reference really well. I usually use my iPad or something else, and this is really good. So let's get started. Hopefully you can also put the image here or somewhere. This is again a beautiful scene from Akko. We have that building on the left. We have this lighter building on the right. We have this interesting architecture here. And the first thing I want to do is just think about how to place everything. And it's a big challenge. Some people ask, like, how are you able to get the locations of everything correctly and the proportions and everything. So usually you use this amazing tool called pencil, but with spontaneous sketching we don't do that. We just live a life of no regret. We just go for it. So I will start with what looks like the most obvious place for me, which is the top right corner of the left building on the left, because it sort of provides me with a good idea of where the top of the painting goes. It's from the middle out, which is good for me, because if you start from the left, you just run out of place. If you start from the right, you also run out of place. By the way, it's gonna be a long video probably, so I hope you will enjoy it. I'll make a time-lapse version as well. You'll probably have already seen the time-lapse version because I'll probably publish it before. Anyway, so I'm gonna start with the corner here. And I'm just gonna try and pull down a line that looks to me like it's gonna be good, and I'm gonna leave a little space here, because if you notice that pointy part to the right has the cross on it, I think it's a church, and so we need a little more room at the top. So I'm just gonna start with maybe this looks like a good place to start, like here. I just marked something like you can barely see it probably, and I'm just starting with one line. So each of these sketches just starts with one line. So I'm just gonna go for it, and hopefully I won't mess things up on the first line. There we have it. The very first line of this painting is always the scariest for me with these spontaneous sketches, but I think I did a good job. Now, I want to set the frame for the size of everything, so I will do something like this. I'll go over this line next, okay? And I think, sort of judging the building, so here's where our relative size goes into the picture. You want to look at this line and sort of compare it to where this line ends. And I think somewhere around here will be good. And all I have to do is just connect these two now. Okay, it's not necessarily the easiest line to pull, but we'll get through it. Okay, so you see it's not perfect. It's a bit wobbly. That's perfectly fine. As always, as I always mention. Now, this beginning will be a little slow. We're going to pick up the pace later on. I'm just going to get in the initial lines, then fill in the details in time-lapse, okay? Now, the next line I want to place is actually this left line, just to close off this side. Looks like a logical thing to do. So I'm just going to pull it down almost completely vertically. I think this is good, like that, okay? Now, excuse me for the angle. As you can see here, the edges of my notebook aren't parallel to the edges of the video. That's because it's at a slight angle, which may also hurt a bit how you see this sketch. I tried going for a better angle, but this was the best I could find, so you'll excuse me for that. By the way, I'm sporting my Superman ring, just to remind myself that everything's possible. For me, at least. Everyone has to believe in themselves, I guess. So the next line is this one. I'm going to very carefully pull it down all the way to the bottom, and I'm trying again to judge and compare it to this one. So I think somewhere around here, is a good point to get it to. So it's almost vertical, maybe a bit to the right. Okay, now this line, I actually, when I'm looking at it, I think it should be a little more, like I have a bit of regret, but screw it. Okay, so this line, I'm gonna just pull it down all the way here. I'm gonna do my best. And for all of you that are worried about making straight lines, you can break them off in the middle. You can create beautiful art, even if your lines aren't straight. That's part of it. I read somewhere that someone said that using a ruler is cheating, and you should draw all the lines by yourself. It's, I think, a comics artist here in Israel. Anyway, so this line looks a little thin when compared to this one. But I think it will be okay. We're just going to make modifications based on it, and it's gonna be good. The next line that really stands out for me is this one. So I'm just gonna pull it out, and it's gonna lead all the way to the edge of the scene. Now the scene is a little more squished in my reference photo, so I'm just gonna end it here, and it's okay. We're gonna leave this sort of open-ended, okay? But the thing is, there's a little bump here in the wall, so I wanna get that in as well. So I'm gonna go all the way towards here, approximately. Just gonna pull this line, okay? Maybe start here. Just gonna get this line in here, like this. And now we have this small break. I think I'm gonna make it a little longer, you know what, like this. And we have this small break here. So I'm just gonna make that dent in the wall, like this. And I'll indicate that so I don't forget why I did it. Just add a line like this. Now I know it's not the most organized approach, but it's spontaneous sketching. It's not organized to begin with. Now I'm gonna add another line here, like this, just to finish off that wall. And I think we're good with this area. There should be another line here, but I just don't wanna get into the tactics of it yet, okay? By the way, I hope there's no like humming or hissing from the computer. It's the first time my laptop is right here. It's the first time I have it so close, so hopefully it doesn't interrupt. So I think now we can go ahead and get these interesting details here, the domey shape, and maybe just a little more of the details, and then time-lapse, because I don't want this video to be super duper long. Okay, now the it's perfect because here we have this small bump because I messed up. So I'm just gonna use it to pull up the right line, the right edge of this church structure. So I'm gonna just go ahead like this, get it here. And now I'm gonna pull up the other line, which is somewhere around here, like this. By the way, this approach is so different from the one I use when I do my preparatory sketches for watercolor. I work really differently. I use a pencil always. I mean, unless I go for a specific look, I'll always use the pencil, and I'll always be very, very light with it. Now here we're talking about final stuff. We're talking about just, you know, getting everything to be final immediately. I'm really attracted to it, by the way. I don't think I'm built for just pure pencil drawings, because it just bores me, you know. I like to put a line and just bam, see it in there. I just love this approach, you know. I talk about it in my course as well. Like, I love the work with ink. A lot of people like, really, everyone's so different in that sense, because a lot of people, like, hate it. They hate the ink, and they couldn't live without their pencil, and it's perfectly fine. It's really interesting to see, actually, how we all have different preferences. Now I'm gonna pull down this line, and as you can see, this one is protruding a bit, okay? And I'm gonna connect it here. And this edge, you can barely see it, so I'm just gonna pull down like this. Done. Okay, now for this part, I wanna assess where it ends at the very top. So it ends a bit lower than this point here, but I think because I got the height a little different, then it will look better if I heighten it a bit. So, and I think it will just look good. So you can change things on the fly if you want to. Oh, my stomach is rumbling. I didn't eat enough, I guess. Hopefully it won't come up in the audio. So like this. Finish it like that. And this edge, so there's the front of the building, and then there's the left side. You can barely see it, so I don't even know if it's necessary to place it in, but I think I will just suggest it like this, you see? I think it was a mistake. I think I shouldn't have, but okay, whatever. sometimes you take risks and they pan out the way you want, sometimes they don't. Now for the cross, it's just one line going like this, and another one due to the angle is like that. Due to perspective and the direction in which we're viewing this from. I'm really gonna get the framework in just for the whole thing and then go for the time lapse. But let me know if you have no problem, like if I go at this pace for the entire this pace for the entire video, it may take like, I don't know, an hour or so, or maybe even more, so without the shading. So let me know if this is still something you'd also like to see, because I think like my longest videos right now are about 40 minutes, 50 minutes, and I see they're accepted well, but I think going beyond that could be a little too much. Of course, there's always the time-lapse version that you can just celebrate the sketch itself and you don't have to like watch a really long video. But anyway, let me know if you prefer sort of a mix between real-time and time-lapse, or you just want to see the whole process. I really don't mind just showing everything. Because when I do the time-lapse, I just sketch kind of without talking, so it's a bit boring. Feels a bit lonely. So anyway, I'm getting the dome here. Like this, I'm gonna get that cross in here. There's this very subtle pointy, but like this, and then cross. What I like about urban sketching and this type of sketching in general is that there's so little pressure on getting everything like to look accurate, and it's just fun. It's just great fun. I may even paint this if I want to, like afterwards with watercolor. Anyway. That was a strong stomach rumble. So, I don't want to get the details in just yet. I think we can continue on with this structure on the left. So we have this balcony here. And you know what? Let's do an interesting thing. I'm going to finish all the left side in time-lapse. And then I'll do all of this in real time. Because this one has just less details. But still enough so you can learn something. So we're going to get through all of that in time-lapse. Then finish all of this in real time. So friends, I'm really near the end of this left building, and some of you who are maybe observant may have noticed, I don't expect you to, but I've made a little mistake here with the balcony. I planned for this to be the ledge and this to be the fence, and then I just ended up not noticing. I don't even know if it comes through too much in the sketch, but anyway, I'm nearly done with this left side. There's this little door here, and you may have seen me like stopping from time to time, measuring, trying to figure out where to place everything. And this is really the process, you know. You just with time you get used to that process of understanding how things relate to one another, and according to that you just do the sketch. Now, the one thing that's still not present here is the shadows, and my only regret with this picture is that I didn't have the chance to take a picture of that scene a little later, I don't remember, just to have a strong sunlight. So it's really not obvious where the light comes from in here. The skies were very cloudy.
And so the bottom, it's sort of the sun comes from the top, but yeah, it looks like it comes from the top right. So I'm just gonna go with it and according to this, finish it. So anyway, let's look at the right side here, at least get started with it in real time. I just see that the cross needs a little improvement, so I'm just gonna do that. And now we can start putting in the details. So here we have a lot of things going on with the structure. So I'm just gonna start where I can understand what's going on, which is, I think, around here. We have this bump in the wall and it starts sort of midway through these two areas. So I'm just gonna drop a line that's parallel to this one. Now there is this small triangle thing going here. So I'm just gonna do that. And this one, in fact, connects all the way here. Well, not exactly, actually. You know what? Let's get the intricacies here. This is going to be interesting. So I'm pulling a line like this, horizontal, and another line like this, horizontal. And then it just cuts off somewhere here because there's a change, a shift in the how the wall is structured. So it gets to this kind of a shape. And this one connects all the way here, okay? This is really subtle details and it kind of takes time to get the hang of three-dimensionality in general and how it works. But because, think about it this way, you have this wall facing us and this one also facing us entirely, but the top area of this wall, this part is facing upwards. So we have this sort of a wall facing towards us, which is this part, and then the part that at an angle, okay? So. And here the angle is even more towards the top. So we have this part here, and then we have this part here. Okay, it takes some time to really get it. And this is a strong focus also in my course. If there's one thing people struggle with, is just understanding how things are structured or built in space. And I think for some odd reason, I was gifted in that sense. So there were times really in the past where I didn't have such a good technique, and still to this day, a lot of things, this is really clear with pencil. If I try to finalize something with a pencil, I really struggle with it. But the understanding of space and how things work in that way is something that for some odd reason I kind of just gifted with it. It's what I feel, at least. I think it's a mix of enjoying things, thinking a lot about how things are in the real world, and it also applies to life in general. I spend a lot of time in my head, which is a blessing and a curse at the same time, because I'm really observant. I can really notice things, how they're built, how they're, like, even in terms of people, I can really notice how people feel, how they, you know, just very perceptive in that way. And this applies also to space and how things are structured. So I really notice a lot of things. And it's also sometimes difficult because your mind is really flooded with information. It's sometimes hard to detach from your own mind and just, you know, live life. Sometimes it's really a big challenge for me. I don't know if any of you can relate to any of this, like really being in your head a lot of the time and thinking about things and overthinking about them. I'm sure a lot of people can say about themselves that they're overthinking. They're the overthinking type. But I take the blessing part here because it's really such a good quality to have, and I'm really happy that I have this perception. It really helps with people, you know, with communication, with just, I think, in many senses helps being a better person because you're more aware of your surrounding. In any case, now we get to something that's actually has some perspective because everything is so flat in front of us. So we're gonna just, this line comes towards us, so it's at an angle. So first I'm gonna build the very left part of that wall. And then I'm just gonna pull a line like this, okay? And it's because it's coming towards us, okay? So I'm just gonna try and understand the angle, something like this. Maybe I have it a little exaggerated, but it's cool. And it's just a brick wall. So all of this is a brick wall. And where do we go from now? We have this line here to close off this part. I did the windows, and because they're to our right, we can see their right edge and top because we're looking at them from below, okay? Again, with this, it's gonna apply as well. There's this dent, or rather hole, in the wall, and I think there's a bell here. And yes, that's a bell. And there's quite a few details inside. I'm just going to try and simplify them like that. But the general gist of it is that you can see the right side of the wall. And the bell, I think, comes here. You can barely see it like this. Okay. And for this one as well, we have the two windows. There aren't too many details on them. So I'm just going to put them in like this. There's bars on these windows. I'm going to indicate them in a moment or two. Okay. Also on this door. And then we have here this very simple, also arch-like window, arc, I don't know, arch or arc. okay, so here we have some more perspective going, so I'm just gonna complete it. I can kind of just close off this wall and not pay too much attention to it. Let's do that. And we have a ledge here that's also conforming to perspective, so I want it to go the same way, okay? And it has like these things. Now, the closer it gets to us, the larger the distance between these bars is. So we have one here, then we have one a little farther, one a little further, one a little further, like this. Okay, this is also perspective. And we have a center line like this as well. Okay, not the most graceful, but it's kind of clear what we're looking at. That's the most important part, that it reads. Now we have perspective here, but it's so much in the outskirts of our sketch. So I'm just gonna go like this, go like that. There's this ledge thing here coming towards us, like this. Oops, like that. Like this. Some of the bars here. Really not that of a meaningful area for the sketch. We have this floor here. I'm just gonna fill in everything I see. Okay. This, now here's a cool part. I don't know, it may be a little hard to see here, but this whole thing is protruding, so we need to add that three-dimensional layer here because we see its edge like that. And we have here some electricity details. So we have this box here with the wires running. I love this old rundown look of old cities. This is, again, Akko, the old city. So you have a lot of things like this, sort of non-graceful, and I really like this character of look. I consider just painting it and giving the shading that way, and I think I will do that. You know what? I will. I'll just paint it and I'll do it all in time-lapse just for our fun. Because now we have sort of the basic layer of the sketch. Just gonna blow my nose. Sorry about that. We have the basic sketch, the entire sketch. Most of the details, most of everything, but it lacks the shadows and sort of the thing that will give it really the separation of understanding what it's built like. So I'm just gonna maybe paint it really a light layer of watercolor, just to give it some volume, and hopefully we'll get the desired result. If not, then you're gonna have to forgive me, because I usually don't color or paint or use watercolor with inked paintings. I usually don't do that, so I'm just less experienced with it. But let's go ahead and try to do that, see what comes out of it, and wish me good luck. So friends, it's so funny, I just can't wait to explain to you. So basically, I used the Micron Pigma pen that I always use, and it just started running all over the place. And let me show you something. I have a few works here in this sketchbook that for which I did use, you see here, I used the same pen. use the same pen here as well. And this one just ran all over the place. And I think it's because I ordered these off of eBay and maybe they're like, I don't know, fake Micron Pigma because it says waterproof and it isn't. Now, the moment I put in the sky and I saw how it smears, I knew it was not salvageable. So I just went with it and gave it this wet look. Did my best to accentuate the dark areas and leave the highlights for the light ones. It's just a matter of, for me, it was like, whoa, I just destroyed the whole thing. But I thought to myself, you know what? I'm going to just stick to my guns, continue working on it and see what I can make out of it, you know? So I'm really, I don't regret it at all. It's very interesting to say the least. Like, it's half ruined, or maybe totally ruined, but I wanted to continue for you guys and just to show you that it's okay to make mistakes. I will publish this, just the painting. I recorded the whole process narrated, without telling you, because I want it to just be as a separate video. So you will get to see more of the process and my thought process and seeing this ruined and sort of, deciding on what to do with it. Okay, so hopefully you still got something out of it. Let's change the angle and wrap up this video.
Friends, I want to thank you for watching. So here's the final result. I find this so funny. If you take one thing from this video, I'll just close the window. If you take one thing from this video is not to order these pens off of eBay, I guess. It was just a good lesson, I guess, in spontaneity and just accepting crap for your work. And I really thought if I should publish it or if I should just cut the video after the sketching stage, which hopefully you got something out of, at least the sketching part. And I decided to put it on because I really want to work on my authenticity and just show you, like, document the whole process of me figuring it out. And this is good to know, like, I won't try to paint stuff I sketch with this anymore. And it's really so weird because, as I showed you, like, I have this one. Sorry, it's a bit blue, the lighting is a bit off, and this one as well. And it's so funny how just one line and bam, it all went. Anyway, this is it. I hope you still enjoyed the video and learned from the sketching stage. As I said, don't forget to follow me on Snapchat and Instagram if you enjoy my videos. I'm posting tons of cool stuff there, like this painting that I just did earlier. And this is it. Also on YouTube, subscribe because I'm putting out so much videos, you just want to be in the loop. And this is it. I'll see you again in another one really soon. Take care.